this is our day two at Mysuru, and we are at the really famous zoo, Mysuru Zoo. So just a couple of things. You can book the tickets, entry tickets for the zoo online. Be here when the zoo opens at 8:30 is what everybody told me. So we followed that and we booked the buggy, which is again something that everyone told us to do. And we're waiting for it. And the first ride, buggy ride, starts at 9. Wow! Wow, it's a lion! Can you see Amuthan?
Yes, it's running.
It's walking. My God, see how magnificent. So this is the male lion we saw in that video, right? இப்படி எல்லாம் முடி
இருந்ததுன்னா
I don't know what is it about Mysuru, but I just love it here. The zoo is beautiful. We planned it well as well, I think, because we aren't excessively tired, and we saw almost all the wild animals here, like cheetah, lion, and behind me you can see the giraffe. It's very well maintained. And not too big, not too small, and very calm. The vibes are very, very nice. So this zoo is something that I would strongly recommend for you to visit, and come at 8:30. The palace was very beautiful, magnificent, resplendent. I don't know what to call it. It was built after the original palace, which was a wooden structure, caught fire during the queen's daughter's wedding. And the queen, this is she ruled for about 7 years because her husband passed away. She was a commoner, King Chamraja Udayar's wife, and she was the one who built this wonderful palace. We took a guide, and it was very, very good because Mr. Deepak Mohan, who was our guide, really gave us so much of insights and information about this palace. And this is a huge, this is a wonderful place that you should not miss if you are in Mysore. And maybe you should plan a visit to Mysore to just see this palace. It's amazing. And after this, our guide also took us to a workshop where the sculptures, sandalwood sculptures, were being made by an artisan whose ancestors used to work for the king himself. And that's the queen statue that's installed recently in the Darbar Hall of the palace.
Now we're about to go on this Tanga ride opposite the palace and enjoy this novel experience that is unique in Mysore.
We are at Ranganathittu Bird Sanctuary, and this is an experience that I have never had in my life. So there's a boating, and there are lots and lots and lots of birds that you can spot. All wonderful, beautiful birds in all different colors. And the best part is the lake has crocodiles. Now, I knew this before and I made sure many times asking many people whether it's safe or not. But I never expected to spot crocodiles myself. So I was reassured many times that it is really, really safe. But when I really saw the crocodiles live in the water, it was real adventure for me. Like for my standard, this is adventure. So this is an experience that you should not miss. Really, really worth it. We came to Venugopalaswamy Temple. It's pretty hot because it's the month of March. But it's I think when we come a little, you know, in a better season, maybe it's a very beautiful temple. However, the authorities are not very people friendly, and I don't know why. Maybe it's just a one-off experience that I had. But the temple is very beautiful. It's an ancient temple and it's situated on the backwaters. So as you can see, it's very nice. We came here around 4:30, but even that was hot. From the time at my school when I was a child, when I read about Brindavan Gardens, I've always wanted to visit Brindavan Gardens. Some important points that I wanted to iterate here. There is a south garden and there is a north garden. So the musical fountain show happens at the north garden. The south garden has a battery operated electric vehicle. So if you reach in the evening, you can see the south garden and then like around 5:30, and then the musical fountain is supposed to start at 6:45. Actually the timing was 6:30 and it was really delayed and started by 6:50. So if you come during that time, you can see wonderful musical fountain happening there. So that is about Brindavan Gardens. They have a boat ride from the South Garden to the North Garden, or you can walk by. There is a huge bridge that's constructed. It's a must watch, must see for people like me who are interested in the historical places. This was also built by Krishna Raja Udayar. And that's how the name for the dam is also. And there is, his summer palace is also visible nearby. But the maintenance is not, you know, up to the mark. There are littering everywhere, too many tourists, and that has to be taken care of. Hopefully it will be. Everything is in divine order. For our dinner, we've come to Rasa, Dhatu, which is an organic restaurant having many vegan options. So we've ordered for walnut banana date smoothie, a vegan omelette. And we're all so exhausted and so hungry after a full day of, and we're really awaiting our vegan food. And the place is like amazing, as you can see. And yeah, and there's vegan cheese pasta. I can't wait to grab it. So this is at Gokulam in Adi Pampa Road.